And now to a woman who, without even knowing it, is breaking down barriers, left, right and centre. Her name is Miriam Silber. Miriam's a devout Muslim, a dedicated company executive and a full-time role model. And she's doing it in one of the toughest businesses around. Here's Miriam with 6.30's Eddie Meyer, would you believe, deep in the South Australian outback.
It's an old world, a tough world, a man's world. And into it has walked a most unlikely person, not simply because she's a woman, but a Muslim woman.
So these are your special sheep?
These are the sheep we use for breeding our own rams.
Yeah, right.
Miriam Silber is a senior manager at Elders, the 170-year-old agricultural business. Born in London, she moved to Australia as a six-year-old and grew up in Adelaide's tight-knit Muslim community, making her career in pharmaceuticals and finance here and in Asia. She moved to Elders a couple of years ago.
I always remember my first day, and I remember getting to my desk and decided I'd go and introduce myself to everyone, and I just thought there were a lot of men around and figured out the women sat on a different floor.
There were,
but just not that many of them. So it was a long time since I was the first woman in a meeting, the only woman in a meeting.
It was, in all senses, a culture shock.
What, you up into the truck, Tappy?
Gary, we run it.
You really couldn't have picked a blokier industry to work in.
That's very true.
Was it a shock to their system?
I think it was, in a lot of ways, and in a lot of other ways it provided opportunity. So in terms of the guys, they're very open and accepting of someone that's different.
It wasn't, though, always easy, not in the beginning, although she gives little away about the battles she's had.
And I would have thought that a lot of the people you're managing would never have had a woman as a manager, let alone a Muslim woman as a manager.
Definitely, and especially someone that doesn't know anything about sheep and cattle. Yeah.
You really did shake their world.
Absolutely, yeah. But they've been great. I've learnt from them and they've learnt from me.
That modesty and an ability to speak to people at every level has smoothed her way in the paddock or at the wool sales.
I guess when she first walked in with the headscarf, we were all a little bit surprised, but certainly once, after 3 seconds of chatting with her, all that just evaporated.
But in this part of Australia, she understands she's a novelty.
Was it ever, do you think, confronting for some people?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. We've been in places where people have stopped me in the street. And random strangers in country Australia stopped me in the street and just said, what are you doing here and why do you wear that thing on your head? Yep.
And so how do you feel when that happens?
That's okay. They've got a question to ask, so you just answer them. And they kind of go, okay then, that makes sense, and welcome to our town and hope you enjoy your stay.
Elsewhere, Miriam's been asked if she was someone's secretary, not maliciously, just trying to work out where she fitted in.
Because it was not what they were used to?
Well, I'm not sure that there are many of me around. I'm not sure there are many Muslim. There aren't many Muslim women who wear a hijab, who actually look like a Muslim woman, in senior business in Australia.
And in this tough and blokey world, Miriam Silber has found a role she didn't expect.
You actually find guys find it easier to talk to you about the hard issues?
Because I would say so.
Yeah,
100%. 100%. They'll talk to me, they'll say, I've got depression, you know, something else is happening there, what do I do? Absolutely. Because I guess I listen more than other people, but I think they find it easier to have that conversation with me than other people.
In the end, Miriam says she does understand why she's seen as a role model for women and Muslims.
I am who I am. So that's the best thing to do, just do your job and be who you are.
Now that's progress.